Let me just say that I thoroughly enjoyed the roll call at the DNC. To me, the roll call was a reflection of the Democratic Party, a party of diversity and inclusion. Some of our friends came in their cultural attire.
We are the Northern Mariana Islands, where our customs, our culture, our land, and our oceans breathe life into our people. The earth is not red or blue. The earth is sick, and we must protect it. Home to some of the living legends in celestial navigation and to some of the friendliest people in the Pacific. We are the blue waves of the Pacific, and we are proud to cast all 11 votes for our MVP, Kamala Harris. Viva Marianas!
We had some places even declare that they want to be states.
And we will work together to make Washington, D.C. the 51st state.
And I love the fact that Puerto Rico did their support in Spanish.
Puerto Rico, how do you cast your vote?
Buenas noches. Puerto Rico, a U.S. territory known as the Commonwealth of Puerto Rico, and the next state of the United States cast its 60 votes para la primera mujer afroamericana de ascendencia asiática y caribeña que será presidenta de los Estados Unidos, Kamala Harris. ¡Viva Kamala!
And we are the party that support LGBTQ rights.
Everybody, I'm Governor Phil Murphy. We're from Jersey, baby. Garden State, we care about protecting women's rights and lifting up vulnerable communities. That's what we mean when we say the Great Garden State.
My name is Dr. Joey Perella, pronouns she, her, hers. I'm a proud resident of the Garden State. I'm proud to stand with Kamala Harris and Tim Walz because they stand with the LGBTQ community.
We are the party of first.
Hey, Donald Santu, I am Governor Noom Young Guerrero, the first female governor of our beautiful island of Guam.
As governor of the greatest state that ever existed. Hey, for New Yorkers, get used to it.
We are Maryland! And we represent Marylanders past and present.
I'm Governor Josh Shapiro. The proud governor of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
And women's rights. And the roll call reflected that.
And I love being a mom. I have two beautiful children, and my husband and I have always wanted a third. But when I got pregnant, doctors told us our baby would never survive. And if I didn't get an abortion, it would put a future pregnancy at risk. But Trump didn't care. And because of his abortion bans, I had to flee my home. There's nothing pro-family about abortion bans. There's nothing pro-life about letting women suffer and even die. I found a way to access abortion care. I am pregnant again.
So it was just a star-studded event, and I love that celebrities came out to show their political support and have a political voice.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here tonight to officially nominate Kamala Harris for president. Turn out for what? Turn out for what? Hey, turn out for what? Yeah, turn out for what? Let's go, let's go. Turn out for what? Hey, everybody get your hands up. Hey, everybody get your hands up. Hey, everybody get your hands up. Now, say, we're not going back. We're not going back. We're not
something to say. I'm Congresswoman Akima Williams, chairwoman of the Democratic Party of Georgia. Georgia, the home of President Jimmy Carter, the cradle of the civil rights movement, where we fight for our freedom. Extremists in Georgia are trying to silence our voices by kicking Georgians off of the rolls and making it harder to vote. But y'all, when we send Kamala Harris to the White House, she'll fight for our freedom to vote, our reproductive freedoms, and our freedom to thrive. In the spirit of good trouble, Georgia cast 123 votes for the next president of the United States.
Greetings from Louisiana, Mr. Secretary. My name is Wendell Pierce, and I'm a proud son of Louisiana. And Louisiana is about family, and I'm surrounded by my family of the delegates of Louisiana.
My name is Anderson Clayton. I have the honor of serving as the youngest state party chair in this country. And North Carolina is the home of folks like Anthony Hamilton. Yeah, Governor Jim Hunt, Dr. Reverend William Barber, Nina Simone, we represent a new South. And we are proud to be that again this year by electing Josh Stein, Allison Riggs, Wesley Harris, Anita Earls, and everyone else that's on our ballot this year. We are going to make sure that we put Democrats on the ballot and in people's hearts and minds. North Carolina gives 131 votes to the phenomenal Kamala Harris.
You know, the Democratic Party is the party of diversity and inclusion. And I think that we will continue to be the party that creates first.
In a letter from the Birmingham jail, Dr. King wrote that progress is not inevitable. We have to fight for it. We have to win it. Kamala Harris will protect the legacy and the progress that we've made by our forefathers and our foremothers, and she will advance it. She will safeguard our freedom to vote by passing the job.